Thanks for joining us, Richard Tuttle, and for giving us this beautiful exhibition. I don't know the weave of textile language. Just a first simple question. The show is a survey of your work with textile from 1967 until today. And how would you sort of describe your interest and your passion and your love of textile? How does it enter into your work?
I don't know. The show is where we tried to define the textile, we tried to show how the textile is used, we tried to make a completely new work using what we have learned in the show. I think we failed in every one of those categories. Therefore, we can justifiably title the show, I Don't Know. I mean, sometimes it's good to know I don't know. It's better to know you don't know than to think you know when you don't know. Of course, painting has been on textile for a long time. The Greeks, of course, taught us that painting is something that comes out of the wall, comes forward from the wall. So of course, fabric, it could come more easily than if it were a wood panel.
Yeah.
And in coming through the fabric, there can be a strengthening rather than a weakening. So all these are brought us to the use of the weave.
You have a collection yourself, and it's presented in the catalog. I think we should mention your collection and your interest also in carpets and these kind of textiles that are not usually in the fine art museums.
I think I'm a born collector, and I like having art in my life, and I find in the textile world, perhaps because the market has not figured out how to charge huge prices, you can find real art in textiles. Real art can come about out of a collective at certain times. And somebody who's looking for art can find art in places where, for example, the market or the art historian or the classic art consumers have not found it yet. I also like the fact that a textile, a work of art, can be folded and stored. You don't have to have it framed on a wall. You don't have to look at it all the time.
Another dimension of this exhibition, another aspect to it, I think we can find also in the title, The Weave of Textile Language. And it's the connection, because you're also a poet, and you have written short texts and introductions or recognitions, you said, to each of the works in the show. And there is also a presentation of your, just a small selection of the hundreds of books you've made. So maybe we should talk something about the sort of connection between textile and text.
I think the main thing I could say at this point is that text and as a word that signifies language, of course, it's written language. Even the spoken language. When I say a word, one could say that I'm covering up all the other words that are at that moment. So the visitor could be somewhat confused in the sense we've tried so hard to say what this show is about in terms of the Turbine Hall and the publication, but if the visitor is saying, okay, what are you saying? Tell me what it is you are saying. I mean, that's when the I don't know comes. So when the same time I'm saying I don't know, I'm supporting the ambiguity of, well, maybe the show is about the textile, or maybe the show is about the text. That's fine as far as I'm concerned. It's better. I mean, the visitor can come, some visitor would be more interested in a textile. I mean, you can, the piece I'm looking at right now is in fact a work of writing. It's called How It Goes Around the Corner. It could might as well be a poem. And some there are issues in there that I really want to share with other people. But at the same time, another visitor could come in and look at it as a text.
Yeah, you have also been described and accepted this description of yourself as a mystic. Okay. So you sometimes seem to embrace the mystery and the not knowing.
For me, what the mystic is a world which is between this world and the world beyond. If each one of us is more comfortable with mystery, we're treat each other in a much better way than if we're afraid of mystery or we're running away from mystery. And a civilization that emphasizes a material world, you have to try hard to find ways to connect with other human beings, because materiality tends to isolate ourselves. And I still feel interest, if you ask, well, what is interesting, and try to answer that question, there's nothing more interesting for a human being than a human being. I mean, we are the most interesting things there are to each other. Yeah. So why are we separating? Why are we building all this materiality between us? Mm. So this whole issue of the text and the textile and where the similarities are and so on is, you could say, a spiritual level designed to connect with the spirit of us all.